break the chains of my muscle-bound body by the true power, not the fake stuff, the true power of relaxation. Think about that for a minute. And welcome to True Power Meditation. Oh, I just got through with a great meditation. And I have been putting off this channel for years. Why? Because I didn't feel like I was worthy of doing it. I really didn't. But I get up, I meditate every morning, and I just feel like I have to say something. I do believe that meditation can save the world. No question about it. Think about it, just off the top of my head, and we'll do an actual video of this down the road. But I'm a retired public school teacher of 30 years, inner city public school teacher, not Country Day Academy for rich people. No. Inner city. I've been on the front lines for 30 plus years, retired now, several years. But I do believe this. If the public school starting in kindergarten, pre-K, would adopt 15 minutes of meditation in the morning, and 15 minutes before kids went home from school, you want to extend the school day a half an hour, 15 minutes, go ahead, just to make room for the meditation. That is everybody. That is the administrators, that's the teachers, that's the kids, that's the custodial staff, the whole nine yards. Everybody just took that time to meditate. How much better off would that school be? It would cure all the problems of the world in that little 15 minutes, but it would help. All the discipline problems in the school are just completely, for 15 minutes, completely turned off and relaxed. No big deal. They just sit, it's on the loudspeaker. Okay, boys and girls, let's get our 15 minutes of meditation. Sit straight in your chair. Relax. I'll see you in 15 minutes. Not a sound. Guys, if that's not a great way to start the school day, I don't know what is. Okay, take out your reading book. Now that does a couple things. That calms, no matter what they came from at home, the situation they came from, it calms them down. It doesn't fix what's going on at home, but it calms them down. Slows their breathing down, slows their heart rate down, and all of a sudden they are an open book waiting for the teacher to help. Now they're going to get revved up for the rest of the day. They absolutely are. Maybe you could add 10 minutes after they come back from recess or lunch. Then another 15 minutes before they go out into the world. Guys, it would change like that. That's not the whole thing. That's not the whole thing. You break the chains of this body, the mind, the body. This break the chains of this muscle-bound body by the true power of relaxation. Not only that, if you meditate in the morning, meditate before they go home, you are contacting God. There's no question about it. You are contacting God in no religious denomination whatsoever. And you never mention the G word, God. Don't even mention it. But that is bringing God, whatever God they have or don't have, that is bringing God into the lives, into the school, into the spirit, without mentioning the word. And you never mention it again. You never mention it once. You never mention it. You just meditate. think these public schools need a daily dose of God without being upfront about it? Not that, you know, a Roman Catholic is not telling a Jewish boy what to do, and a Jewish boy is not telling a Muslim boy what to do, and on and on and on. It's all inside. It's there for them, whether they know it or not. Change the world. You break the chains of your muscle-bound body by the true power of relaxation. I have a health and fitness business, and I work with lots of athletes. And if you look at the athletes, the landscape, every single one of them is hurt. This is baseball season. They can't run to first base, literally, without pulling a muscle. Why? They're working out all wrong. They're tensing up. There's steroids in there, and they're juiced in there. They can't move. There is no relaxation whatsoever. None. Break the chains of your muscle-bound body by the true power of relaxation. And how does that come? The only way it's going to come is through meditation. The only way. And then when you get yourself centered, when you get yourself relaxed, guys, when you are relaxed, you are better with your loved ones. You are better with your enemies. Think about that. This guy that's after you for, or gal that's after you for, ever since you can remember, all of a sudden you're relaxed. Oh, I'm sorry you feel that way. Well, I'll keep that in mind. And we'll talk some more. Don't ever talk to me like that. See what I'm saying? Break the chains of your muscle-bound body by the true power of relaxation. Guys, that's a quote. I'm not sure where I found it, but that was in my mind for about an hour and 10 minutes. That's all I can think of. Sometimes I put these quotes in my mind, Our Father, who are some, you know, prayer or something. Sometimes they just come to me. Comes from God. There's no question about it. In different ways. Comes from the spirit. Comes from the heavens. Comes from the core. Comes from your universe. Comes from your energy. Call it what you want. But you're better with your friends. You're better with your enemies. You're better with your loved ones. You're better at your job. You're better driving the car. It's as simple as that. The true power of relaxation. That's it. That's it, Chico. The world and everything in it. Anyway, eat and drink your fruits and vegetables. And eat your starches. Meditate and live your life with true power. Not the fake stuff, true power.